Hello fellas, I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. Today, as promised fellas, we are doing a tech tree showcase of the Super Conqueror. The quick thoughts about this tech tree. The most painful tanks for me is the Churchill 1 and Churchill 7. The Bled Prince is okay-ish for me. It's not the best tank in the world of tanks. It's not even close for T29, it's not even close for IS. It's not even close for Polish tier 7 tank, which I can't remember the name, but for me it was okayish grind. After that, Caernarvon is going to be ideal tier 8 tank, and Conqueror and Super Conqueror, they are very, very good too. Although I must admit I'm not heavy tank player, so you know, I don't really like heavy tanks, but it's only my personal opinion. Speaking of more things, fellas, we are going to go in the battle with a Churchill very, 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 very soon, right? And before going into the battle, fellas, pew, 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 check that corner. Okay, and we are going to have a next stropple for next tech 3 showcase, which is going to be tank destroyers, tank destroyers is going to be the next tech 3 showcase, so you can vote for whatever tank destroyer you want to, right? Also, one more thing, I have played one battle with a Churchill as my warm-up, since it is a morning and I did not have the most pleasant gaming experience with this tank. Hopefully, it is just a warming up, right? So, without further ado, let's go, right? Let's go! Clerked into the battle, I hope for city map like Himmelsdorf, Ernst, and tier 5 matchmaking. Yes, yes, yes. Naive skill. I know. You need to hope for the best, right? Or maybe you can be that person which is hoping for the worst. Kempinovka with 3 artists, and after that, when you are getting only 2 artists, you are, hey, I'm lucky. Yep. Tier 7. Ooh, tier 7, no artists. Okay. So, let's think what we can do right there. By the way, this is my morning coffee. Bon appetit. Cheers, fellas, or bon appetit if you are eating. So, what can you do in the tier 7 matchmaking with a Churchill? Apart nothing. Yep. Nothing. I mean it, fellas, I don't see the point to go in front and try to get some use of all this. I don't know, I mean, you are pretty much 3 shotable for Tiger P, Ikea, M6. It's going to be a very hard battle, but let's stop complaining for a second and let's try to get maximum use. By the way, am I taking a replace out of somewhere and I am just commenting over this because both of my hands is here. Yes, fellas, especially pay attention to this ass dance. Juxt, 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 juxt. So, as you can see, I am definitely using the pre-recorded battles, and I would never ever do that live, you know? If I'm doing the things live, I can tell you one thing, my hux is simply not working, that's why. Okay, M4, can we see this M4 idea? It's half of the trouble here, to be honest. Yeah, they have a Tiger P sniper schnitzel. But it's not that bad. Oh, Cromwell. Look at this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful track. Oh, this is beautiful. So right there, I am just trying to punish this Cromwell for his mistake which he have done here, right? That's exactly what I want to do. And it goes for many tier 5 or tier 6 tanks when you are bottom tier. Don't play with them like, you know, like you are the most powerful tank in the world of tanks and you are the unstoppable beast. No, things is not going in that way. Remember my words. And you know, it does. If you are playing with a cover one and you are playing against the tiger, let's get real. Tiger is going to eat cover one more likely. If you're wondering what I'm trying to do right here, I'm trying to get some blind shots into that M4. But I'm not hitting any. Maybe right there? No. No blind shots, fellas. Okay, let's try to make a pressure then. Most important thing for us is to deal with those two guys over there. Whenever we are going to finish them up, our gaming experience will be way better, right? Mm-hmm. It's okay. We are trying to pick the good angle right here. It's fine. Relax. Take it easy. Easy peasy, fellas. Easy peasy. This guy is dead in a second or two. It's okay. I took one more for the team, but we eliminated him. And the funny thing of all this skill is saying, but don't play like crazy, man, and don't go in front. Meanwhile, skill is on the full Ferrari mode against the tanks, and he is like, in the first lines with a Churchill against the tier 7s, and he's dealing with everyone with a smile on his face, for real. Play Tiny Touch safer, okay, when you are a bottom tier, because it's simply not worth it. What I'm doing right here, I noticed the gap in the enemy's defense. That's why I went quite some in front, okay? Other than that, I don't really recommend to do that. And look, you are playing with a heavy tank and you are meeting a tier 6 scout. A tier 6 scout will eat you. Tier 6 scout won't even ask your name, and tier 6 scout will show a big fat middle finger for you. So that was the game with the Churchill. On top of that, fellas, I'm going to make one more game with this tank. Why so? I believe a lot of people are struggling with this tank, and maybe next time we are going to get a better matchmaking. So let's see how the things will go. If we will get another bad battle, let it be. I can tell you that Churchill is not... It's not even close for being a good tank, and it is not the tank which I would enjoy the most. So let's cut the video here, and I am going to come back whenever we are going to get Mark of Excellence, whenever we are going to finish this game, okay? Let's go. And we are back. I got myself a blueprint, some of the blueprints. This is good feature, and I am enjoying it. You are getting stuff for free, so why not? Anyways, that was defeat. We took one for the team, and imagine, when you are top on of experience in the tier 7 game with a Churchill 1, then you know you did not have the best team ever, right? Okay, let's go once again. Klurkst, let's click in the button, and hopefully we are going to have a better... This is a disappointment face, fellas. Okay, let's talk about this battle, and without any sarcasm whatsoever. Now, pay attention. What kind of map we have here? We have a map which is good for scouts, mediums, tank destroyers, but not a heavy tanks. Not a bottom heavy tanks. There is two effing artists in both sides. There is top light tanks, which I can't even outspot in my dreams. After that, we have couple of the cover 85s, which is going to shit on me without asking my name. Jack Panzer, good luck outspotting that. Couple of more scouts, which will outspot me any day. Cover 1, which we can deal with, T-34, which probably would eat me with his DPM. Same goes for this guy, Stug, good luck outspotting him, and ELC, MIX, and another Arta. This is like the worst matchmaking right here, and as you can see here, 6 scout tanks. 6. 6 of them. 6 scouts. This is just a brutal madness, and I can't predict this game is going to be bad already. Why am I saying so? Because of this kind of matchmaking. It's just disgusting, and I'm telling that, fellas. Ooh, snapshot. Nice. Skill, stop crying and start doing the things you okay, Roger, Dad, sorry, fellas. Peace. Unstoppable Churchill. Just no in the face for a tier 7 light, and we got him, fellas. I'm just crying to make it more intense, okay? That's why I'm crying. In reality, we are going to deal with everyone with a big smile on our face. And this is definitely not a sarcasm. Not at all. Oh, and you know what is the funny thing of all this? Tier 6 is going to be the same. Tier 6, fellas, is going to be the same. Okay, I was thinking about going like this, but I changed my mind immediately. I can't do that. I can't push through the middle. Because it is just simply not worth it, and it's way too risky. So I believe we are going to head to the base, and hopefully that will work good. By the way, it is 4 espressos, and it's so cheers, fellas. Okay, this wolf pack of the light tanks, they are going in front. Our cover 2 is yelling for help, and unfortunately, but we cannot help him. He is pretty much dead meat. Whenever we are going to get spotted right there, Arta is going to eat me. Sherman penetrated this light tank with a high explosive gun. That was impressive. And Arta penetrated the T-71 for 500, by the way. Those scouts should stop camping, I think. What do you think about that, fellas? Because I think it's the case. I want to cross like this right here, and hopefully we will get some use. Maybe this T-71 is going to go like more aggressively over there. No, it is not looking like it. And now I want to take this position. Look, this person is getting outspotted by this T-71, da. And that T-71 da plus Artis is just claiming this guy life, plus they have a cap and we don't have hit points to decap it. Ay. Definitely not a our Arta blind fired people in the cap and he decapped. Good clicker. Oh my bananas, that was good. And that was good. I need to stay away from this guy because he is spotted all the time and he is going to take one for the team for obvious reasons, right? Keep that in mind. And right here we are simply waiting until enemies will try to make some kind of pressure. Like this guy is doing pressure, he is going to kill our friend right here. Can I deal with this guy? Hopefully yes, if I'm lucky. After that T-71 dies going for us. That means he have a clip, if I'm not mistaken. And since he have a clip, I'm dead. Yay! Here you go. This is the tier 5 tank with which you are going to deal with, or with which you need to deal with. Here you go. This is fellas. Let's get real. I can get a good battle with this tank, but it's going to take 10 games. And you know what? I don't want to show you epic game. Why so? If I want to show you epic game, I can take that from the vote replays, and then I can say, oh, such an amazing tank it is. No, it is a pile of effing shit. This tank is pretty much bad at everything. Armor is not good. Currently in 2019, we are living in the pretty much gold meta. You can't do shit. I played 3 games with this tank. You have seen only 2. All of them was garbage, and I'm not going to go for another game. This is the reality. This is the gaming experience which you are going to have with this tank, and no problem. It is my pleasure to show you all this stuff. So let it be. We are leaving the Churchill 1. Let's go with the Churchill 7, which is pretty much the same tank, but it's one tier higher. So what we are going to use on this vehicle, this is the right gun to use. You have 140 average damage, and you have okay penetration. It's not that bad, so it's literally the same tank, just one tier higher, right? So I believe, without talking too much, yay, I received a lot of things because of the World of Tanks birthday. Very nice. So yeah, three games with a Churchill, all of them was bad. Hopefully the tier 6 will bring us more luck. Let's go into the battle, shall we? Easy. Let's go. Click. Hopefully, fellas, hopefully this tier 6 will work better for us. Tier 6 matchmaking, which is looking kind of okay-ish. Bad thing of all this is there is two artists. There is two very dangerous artists. M44 can eat me without asking my name, and it's going to be very, very dangerous. So, what kind of situation, what kind of opinions we have, options we have with this vehicle? Option number one, we can go in next to the red line, 1-2 line, and we can cry in the corner. Option number two, we can cry in the corner just in the start of the battle, because we have this map and two artists. Option number three, we can stop crying and we can go into the middle, and we will try to get some use of the people which is playing in the Foxtrot Zero, so on the hill, we will have a spotter. And option number three, option number four, sorry, I can't take this position over there myself. As you can see, I'm going in the middle and I will try to get some kind of use here. Fingers crossed, bless me, fellas. Ooh, this tech tree showcase started with a spice. Mwah! But in the same time, I knew what will happen, and some people in the Twitch, they said, hey, Skill, are you looking forward to play with the Churchills while you are doing the Tech 3 showcase? Yes, fellas, this is exactly what I'm looking for. So here you go, fellas, this is the gaming experience which you are going to get. But wait, whenever you are going to move a little bit up with the tiers, from tier 8 to tier 10, it's going to be beautiful. It's going to be very, very nice. You are going to have reasonable good alpha damage. You are going to have a lot of good things, I'm telling you. So yeah, it's very, very important. I'm going with a snapshot. Oh my bananas. What is this RNG? What is this RNG, fellas? What we are doing right here, we are trying to snipe those people which is playing on the hill, right? This is my main mission right here. And hopefully everything will go well. Plus, on top of that, I want to destroy this house. And now if their spotters will get spotted, it's going to be a good day for us also. You can blind fire this bush yourself. There is quite a big chance I'm going to catch that Type 64 which is sitting in the bush over there. There is a chance, and he's down to one shotable, so why not? Plus this tank have quite some ammunition, so I can go with the blind shots all day, all night long. That's what I can do. I am kind of afraid to get spotted from that stairwell, so I am trying to pay attention every time into the maxi map, right? This guy is the most dangerous tank. And obviously I'm missing the killing shot, please, game. Thank you. Very good. And right there, look, why do I like middle with this, with any tank, any heavy tank in this map? I love the middle because from the middle you have amazing crossfire on the people which is playing right there. And usually there is quite some of them which is playing right there. And you can simply claim their life even without asking their name. That was very, very good. And we have a reasonable start already. Would I have the same start with a tier 5 shitter in this map? Yes. By the way, funny fact, Jumbo, do you see this tank? Easy 8. He's using the derp gun, and this is not the right way to play with that Jumbo. But this guy doesn't know that, so he's going to pay his price. If you want to play with a derp gun, fellas, play with a Jumbo. This easy 8, it's just no. Plus, he doesn't have any armor, so you can be sure about it. He's just going to die. Anyway, so far 900 damage, easy game. And looks like enemies have no team right there. Obviously, Arta is hitting us and this clicker is sitting right there. But not much what we can do for him. I'm not going to escape from this position yet. The thing is, I don't really think it's worth it. Oh, ho, ho, so this guy was spotting me all the time. Very, very, very nice decision from this guy. I hope he's going to die though. I mean, we have two sniper schnitzels, cover twos, but for them to hit that guy. And let the Armageddon begin. What that means, whenever I'm going to get spotted, they are going to hit me for certain amount of damage plus certain amount of distance. It's just not very enjoyable and not very good. But hey, that's what you are getting while playing with the heavy tanks, and especially while playing with the Churchill, which is very, very slow and it's just... This tank is automatically going to take quite some for the team. Right here, I want to cross. I know. And I'm dead. Okay, let it be. I just finished my torture right here and I thought I can cross in time. Then I will have more enjoyable gaming experience, but no. So, same thing goes for a Churchill 7. If you are playing with this tank, you don't want to see open maps at all. You want to play in the maps, you don't want to see Kampanovka or Prokhorovka or something. All you want to do, you want to play against the same tiers or lower tiers in the Himmelsdorf, in the Ensk, in the Paris, in whatever city map you like, right? If you are getting open map, good luck, it's not going to be good. Unless you want to be like this cover 2 and snipe from the red line. But in the same time, I cannot blame the cover 2 for that. Why so? Cover 2 is the best sniper, don't you know that, fellas? Meanwhile, cover 2 is using Arta to spot for them. They're using Arta to spot for them. Okay, we are done with a tier 6, but skill, why you're not playing another game? Damn it, fellas. How you dare to ask another game with this tank? Okay, let it be. I will play one more battle for the sake of my heart, and maybe we are going to get this city map, which is going to work, which is going to treat us properly, hopefully. Let's see. Fellas, I hope you are enjoying this Tech 3 showcase as much as I do. I'm having a blast. No joke, fellas, I'm having a blast. Oh, those Churchills. Very enjoyable. Anyways, Arta top player of the game, unexpected, and enemy light which did the things properly, which spotted well, and Prokhorovka, Kampanovka is the game of the lights. If you have a good light, you are going to win the game. If you don't have a good light, you are going to lose the game. So unfortunately, but that happened once again. So game, there is two sides of yours. Could you please give me a good map? Himmelsdorf, Ensk, anything. Okay. Fellow tankers in the YouTube, hello once again. This is the gaming experience which more likely you are going to have with Churchills. No bullshit right there. That line is painful unless you like to be like a snail. You like to go like this. You like to be like a snail, which is taking one for the team. And let's get real. When you are getting this kind of matchmaking, you can simply go and F yourself. So yeah, it's quite sad, but instead of complaining, we will try to get some kind of use right there. So once again, I hope you are enjoying this. But wait, whenever we will reach the tier 8, tier 9, tier 10, it's going to be way more enjoyable. Tier 7 might be enjoyable too, it depends on the maps. Everything is depending on the maps with those vehicles, that's for sure, so yeah. Again, a team which is too blind to look into the map, our Pantera is saying. Yeah, I'm Churchill, what do you expect from me? I don't have map awareness. I'm just playing, I'm just traveling right here and I'm enjoying this tank view. Let's make a screenshot. Pyongst! Screenshot done. Very nice. Very, very, very nice, fellas. Just beautiful. That's what I am doing when I'm playing with a Churchill in this certain situation. And before people will say, Eskil, you are a heavy tank, why you are not in front? If you would pay attention right there, you would notice what kind of matchmaking we have, what kind of map we have, and I do not want to go in front because it's simply not worth it. If I will do that, I will take one for the team and it's going to be game over. So instead of doing that, I will try to get at least reasonable okay score by saying that to snipe like 1000, and after that I'm going to feel way more happier. That's it. Do you want to highlight what will happen in this map and in this battle? This guy will die soon, this guy will die soon, this T29 will try to retreat like this, he will get effed by the people which is playing over there. This is the quick summary what will happen very, very, very soon. And me as a Churchill, I am just trying to punish enemies for their stupidity. And this guy is crossing and my mission is to punish him for as much as I can without taking too much for the team. So that happened right there. And this Oni, teddy bear, meatball, Godzilla, however you are calling this vehicle, he's just going straight and he's dealing with quite some people over there. Meanwhile, we are getting effed up by enemy Artas, which is completely understandable. I'm sitting in the standard position right there, so not a big deal. And right there, I hope they will start moving a tiny touch more in front, and hopefully we can punish them for their stupidity. And right there, this person made a mistake. This Tiger P made a big mistake, and that's what you need to rely with this vehicle. That's what you want to see from the enemy team. And then you can say, and you can try to punish them whenever they are making mistake like this. To move for yourself in front with this tank, oh boy, it is not very enjoyable. It's not the thing which I recommend to do, and this is just not how you're supposed to play. I know, but heavy tank and so on, fellas. On paper, a lot of things are looking very, very nice, and if you are doing the things which is saying on the paper, you know, not all the time this kind of stuff is true, right? Speaking of this tank, speaking of this situation, it's just not how the things supposed to be done. So we are just trying to play the game and we are trying to enjoy the game and we are trying to get maximum use of the situation which we currently have. And this situation, let's get real, is not looking super duper hyper turbo good by any means, right? Meanwhile, we are going per more backwards and hopefully we can punish this Löwe. Löwe died, but Löwe did not die for us, which is kind of understandable. And now we are going with a gold ammunition against the another Godzilla or Oni or however you are calling that tank. And yes, we are wasting our gold ammunition right there, but what do you expect me to do? There is a tiny chance we can penetrate his boob in front. This is one out of 10. Come on, one more. Game with a blind shot. No! Okay, one more. And for the love. Everything is for the love, fellas. Everything is for the love. Very nice. Beautiful. Okay. Now let's think about that progetto. I'm going for that progetto, Lorraine. Yes, yes, yes. I know what you want from me. Meanwhile, progetto is playing over there, and I don't really want to go for that guy anymore. I want to go up once again like this, and maybe I can get some ass shots into this guy, which is playing around this area. That would be the best thing. Meanwhile, the T29 is making a crossfire on this guy over there, which is not very good, but not much what I can do about that. And if that Lorraine is expecting me to go in front or something, probably he doesn't know my speed. At least that's what I assume. And this progetto is just going for that guy right there. Now this progetto is going to turn around and hopefully he will go like this. Premier shot. Nah. Bounce. Nah. Miss. Ooh, fellas, gaming experience. Gaming experience. Yep. If you think it's driving me nuts, you are wrong. I am enjoying myself. And Churchill 1, Churchill 7 is those tanks which is solid banana out of 10, which is super duper hyper turbo enjoyable tanks to play. And it's just beautiful. So stop complaining already, fellas. Stop it. This guy should be able to deal with a progetto, but in case, if it's not going to be in case, I'm just going for that progetto myself, right? I have some hit points, so I could even take one or two for the team, and I really want to deal with this guy before it's too late. So one into the side. I'm trying to make some kind of angle right here, and this Lorraine killed him. Hip hip hooray. We might win this battle because of this Lorraine. Well, since he's a top tier, it would be shame if we would not win this. Good job, Lorraine. Very, very nice. Okay, so let's try to predict what is happening right here. Where is that P-43? I have no clue. Where is that Schlüner Emil? I have no clue. Where is that Skoda in the balcony? Speaking of this Lorraine, apparently this Lorraine is going to snipe with a full hit points from the back right there. So I'm taking my good job Lorraine back. This is some tea, fellas. I am taking my good job back. And what we are going to do? Meanwhile, while playing with the Churchill fellas, you can enjoy the views. You can imagine like you are a tourist in I don't even know. And you are looking into the mountains. Very nice. Very beautiful. I hope you have a winter coat and your hat. Speaking of hat. Yeah, stop it, fellas. It's cold out there, okay? It's cold out there, so... Actually, you know what? I have a feeling. Hat is not going to save me from all this uno momento. Okay, now I am a proper tourist, everything is fine. It's winter, fellas, please understand me, it's not that easy as you might think. Yes, meanwhile we are traveling, fellas. We are simply traveling. Well, look at the bright side, at least we have a fresh air, right? At least it's something. Meanwhile, this Lorraine is joining us right here, so it's very, very nice. Very nice. She is traveling too, by the way. What do we want to do next? In my opinion, I am going to take this bush over there. Actually, Lorraine is trying to take this bush. Okay. Fair enough. So I will just make a pressure for the enemies. Yes, 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 this is the Churchill gaming experience, fellas. Yes, this is a Churchill gaming experience. Even Cat is saying, what the effing F is this shit? But hey, while you are traveling through the map, while you are exploring the map, you can see the most beautiful things out there. For example, look at this tree. This tree is looking very, very nice. It's just amazing. Oh my bananas. Very nice. This is the experience which you can expect with a Churchill, fellas. And I hope you are having as much fun as I do, because it's quite funny for me. Okay, so we managed to travel through to the enemy base, and 4 minutes left of the battle. Hip hip hooray, I am feeling happy. And they are dying. And listen, fellas, enemies are melting, enemies are dying. Very, very nice. Arta. Arta have definitely Arta map awareness right here. Definitely Arta map awareness. And now I want to figure out where the Stunner Emil is. Is that Stunner Emil over there? No, he is in the corner. Lorraine is going to take one for the team if he's not a pussy, and he's going to clip him. So yeah, that was the winter map, fellas. It was most enjoyable gaming experience which I ever had. And hey, 1,400 damage, okay, with this thing and the minus 2 matchmaking. It cannot get any better than that. So yeah, I tried to do my best, and that was as much as I could get. Do we have any blind shots? Drums. Let's see. Easy, we have 2 blind shots. Easy, 1.6. Very, very nice. That was as much as we could get in this game, fellas. As much as we could do, and it was interesting. So since we finished our tourist trip and everything, give me some time to fix my things, to get rid of the hat and my jacket, or however you are calling this, and then we are going to go with the Blood Prince. By the way, funny thing, Blood Prince, in my opinion, is better than those two tanks. So with the Blood Prince, even though you have only 150 alpha damage, you have way better armor than with a Churchill. So I believe with the Blood Prince we are going to start really enjoying the games. I know. A lot of people is thinking, why you like the Blood Prince and so on. This is not my favorite tank, but I can play with it, and I do not have the most terrible gaming experience while playing with this tank. This is the highlight, what I want to make. Anyways, be right back, fellas. We are back. Let's go with the Blood Prince in the game, right? Hopefully, fellas, hopefully everything will work well, and we are going to get something nice. Hopefully the game is going to treat us better than the game treated us before. Fingers crossed. Come on, game. Show us some love. Game is saying, wait, you will have a super conqueror soon. Why you are complaining? You are going to enjoy your gaming experience way more. Very, very soon. This is my cat, fellas. She's prepared for the summer already, and she's looking gorgeous. You can call her a lion, okay? You can call her, well, actually, wait a second. You can call her lioness. This is the right way to say that, right? Okay, boys. We have a Himmelsdorf. A tier 10 battle, though, but it's not looking that bad, fellas. It is not looking that bad. So what do we want to do in the Himmelsdorf? First of all, we will start everything by piri going through the street, through the middle street. After that, we will cross through the open field and we will cut banana. This is the plan. We'll see how the things will go. Fingers crossed. Let's go. Type 64 manager to punish our team here. And he crossed himself. Okay, let it be. I'm accepting that. There is no clickers which could punish me, so I'm feeling very, very well with that. We have IS3 in banana, and you know what? I have a feeling I will go through the map already. Wait a second, this MX made a mistake. I can see that already. He is making mistake. Are you? My cat is not even happy about this guy mistake. Yeah, I know cat, he's making mistake. And that's it. And now we are using our DPM and Bled. And here Bled Prince is kind of shining, okay? And plus fire hacks as usual, everything is fine. Okay. Right here, boys, we are just making pressure. Do I want to make a pressure? This is the question. You know what? Yes, I want to make a pressure. How exactly do we want to do the things? We are crossing through the middle. And we are going to kill this guy like immediately. Boom. He is dead. After that, we will try to figure out the things how to fight against the people which is playing over there. This is very, very important. So with the Blood Prince, we are getting closer. And this guy will try to be safe from us. What do you think? Is he going to try to be safe from us? It's too late, sir. It's too late. Blood Prince have okay-ish armor compared to the others which we had before. So I'm definitely not afraid of this kind of shit. And now this guy is crossing. We are punishing him in the back. Yeah, it's just way more beautiful. Look at the Blood Prince armor, fellas. That's why I'm not complaining about this tank at all. Like, at all. Just because of this beautiful armor. Yeah, it's not ideal. It's not the best tank in the world of tanks. But at least you can start getting some use of all this already, right? And look, speaking of the DPM and everything, we can already start doing the things like a proper heavy tank do, right? Look at this Tiger. He's taking one for the team and Oni apparently is using the DPM gun, which is a smart thing. Now we are loading gold. But skill you gold? No, why you are loading gold? Fellas, it's very important because this guy... he have 300 alpha damage, I have only 150, and he have armor of the Godzilla, and it's not that easy to penetrate Godzilla right here. I was aiming for a track, but I did not manage yet to hit him, which kind of sucks, but let it be. And now this person is ignoring me, and that was bad. We sended him back to the garage. Very, very nice. Okay, P43 hit me once in the ass. More likely he's going to hit me once again before I will escape. But luckily that was not the case. And we can make a pressure like this. Good map. Quite good matchmaking. And Blood Prince is shining. I'm telling you, it's not a bad tank. Because your armor is starting to feel already. And yeah, against the tier 9s, let's get real, it's not going to be amazing, but against the tier 8s, tier 7s, and I'm not even talking about the tier 5s, you can actually be like a heavy tank, and it's very, very important part of all this, okay? It's super important part of all this. P43 is right there, and he is trying to find a shot on me, but I don't really care about this guy. Good luck for him. Meanwhile, we are seeing the Panther over there. I would love to finish this Panther in the butt. And now, maybe this IS-2M and this TVP-WTO. ISM is going to deal with this IS, but I will deal with this TVP-WTO in a second. Actually, in 2 seconds. Now, Mr. IS. The question is, can we deal with this guy? This is the main question. Yes, he missed that. Ooh, gold on. I have gold too, sir. I have gold too. Beast. Mm-hmm. This guy is going. That was stupid by him. This guy managed to penetrate me. Not much what I can do about that. He have alpha damage, which is super important part in this situation right there. But it's okay. Let it be. And he killed me. It's not a bad game by any means with a Blade Prince. Solid 3000. It was pretty much good. I wasted too much time on that on E. I could aim better those shots instead of trying to hit their... his boobs, chest, or however you are calling that. But other than that, it was fine. And that was the game with the Blade Prince. I'm not going to do another one. And I hope I explained you everything how to play with this tank. The most important thing with this vehicle is very, very simple. You need to make some kind of angle, right? And if you are playing against the higher tiers, you can stay hold down, you can use gun depression, and you can get quite some use of all this. And for me, Blade Prince is quite enjoyable tank to play. I did everything what I could. Unfortunately, our tier aids did not carry their weight right there, and this guy carried their team, which is completely understandable, and I'm not complaining. That kind of stuff is happening. You can't win them all, right, fellas? And now, fellas, we are going to enjoy ourselves with almighty Caernarvon. It's just amazing. And let's check out, do we have a top models? Yes, we have top models. We are more likely going to play two battles with this vehicle. And what about this tank? Why this tank is so good and why everything is so beautiful with a Caernarvon? Answer is extremely simple, fellas. This tank is hull down beast. With this tank, if you have a hull down position, you can shit on everyone with your amazing DPM. And speaking of mobility, obviously it's not excellent, but it's not terrible. It's not like you are moving with a Churchill, with a bicycle, or how it's called when you are I can't remember the word, but it's never mind. What I meant to say, fellas, I can't remember that tool or whatever, but you are basically climbing up like this, klunkst, klunkst, and you are going with your feet like this. Probably I will get some comments, and then hopefully I will get the answers in the comment section down below. I hope so. Anyways, what we are planning to do? Easy. We are going to go into the heavy line and we are going to eat enemies without even asking their names, which is very, very nice, while drinking tea. Or while drinking coffee. Or while vaping. Beautiful. And now we can play the game. Okay, so what do we want to do in this map? First of all, we want to take a hotel 3 golf 3 position, then we can take that hull down area, and then we can shit on everyone with a big smile on our face. This guy try... one more thing which I forgot to mention with this vehicle, the gun handling of this tank is actually very, very decent. Well, it's not decent, it's amazing. Gun handling is very good on this tank. And right there from this situation, I believe you can see our projectile and our Vaza is having a crossfire on the enemies. Not much what those people could do. And this tank, the most important with this tank is to use the DPM and in the same time to use your gun depression. When you are top tier with this tank, you don't even need to use the armor. You just need to go in front and you can deal with pretty much everyone. But what to do in the situations when you are not top tier and it's happening? For example, not in this game, okay? Definitely not in this game. Look, the new tank. What's up? What is your name? Are you enjoying your new free tank? Yes, 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 you are enjoying yourself. Good to hear that. How about your weak spot right there? Oh. Oh, he's dead. That was fast. Penetration wise, 220, which is not bad, 252, which is not ideal, but it's more than enough. And right here, all you need to do, you need to push in front, and you are going to be golden. You can deal with all of them. That's it. This cupola is penetratable of the super mutant, keep that in mind. A lot of people, I noticed that quite some people don't know how to deal with a mutant, and and a lot of people is thinking that vehicle have quite good armor. No, it's not the case, fellas. Armor of the mutant is not ideal, and it's not even close for being very good, okay? Anyways, the side of the can. Look what we are doing in this battle. We are just going full in, and we are saying, yeah, this tank don't have amazing alpha damage, but look at the DPM. DPM of this vehicle is just crazy bananas. Look, pay attention what we are doing. We are just going straight through the enemies without asking their names. What I don't really like about this map, enemies have disadvantage to play in the heavy line, right? That's what I noticed, and I believe it's not even discussable, right? This side cannot play over there, and it's not very, very good, and I think this map is kind of shitty balanced and everything, but hey. We cannot change it, so let it be. The first battle with this vehicle, at least so far, 2,300 damage. Obviously not golden score, not the best score in the world of tanks, but we try to do our best. Speaking of the high explosive penetrations of this tank, it's not ideal, it's not excellent. What I would love to do you see this Borshchik going down the speed? Going down the hill. Nah, and Borshchik is taking one. I want to have, in fact, I want to have high explosives. Maybe he's going to peek here, and maybe we are going to punish him. You never know. I believe you can hear a weird noises in the background. My cat is chewing something. My cat is running through the room and saying, "Summertime." Probably this is the case. Oh, Borshchik, I have high explosives, 360 in the face. Good day. So, I still have the same opinion about this tank which I had before. This tank is amazing. It's a tier. Remember there used to be a time when T-32 used to be that, you know, tank with which you could flex. When you could say, oh, this is good, this is very good tank. Currently, this tank took over it, okay? I think this tank is simply better than a T-34 was in the past, and this tank is amazing. Look at the DPM of this tank. Pay attention, fellas. Look at the DPM. It's crazy how fast you can deal with everyone, and you can just eat them. Okay. And the question is, where is that Arta? Is that Arta over there? Like here? No. So Arta was right there. I don't really think we are going to get one more shot right there, but you never know. I'm just going to take this bush. And I'm going to wait until Arta will get spotted. Arta. Defender, sniper, schnitzel. You know what is that? That was like roughly 450 meters distance, and you managed to hit that. He probably yelled Russia. Well, one or another way that happened. It's fine. As you can see, fellas, first game. Good map for this tank. We had opportunity to play hold down 3,500 plus 500. I'm telling you, from now on, right, when you are getting yourself, speaking of the grind itself, right, whenever you are going through the painful tank, Churchill 1, Churchill 7, fuck those tanks, after that, okay-ish tank, at least for me, Bled Prince. Now, with the Caernarvon, you are going to start to enjoy yourself. Obviously, I'm not talking about the stock tanks right here, because majority of the stock tanks, without any doubts whatsoever, they are crap. Let's get real. They are just crap. So, what can you do? By the way, I really love matchmaking changes, and what they have done with the matchmaking, it's solid banana out of 10. It's just beautiful. You can say whatever you want. The tier 8 matchmaking is looking way, way, way better than it was before. At least that's what I think. And it's my opinion. Bad thing of this battle, they have Arthas. I would love to go through the rails, but I'm paranoid by the clickers. I truly am. So instead of going through the rails, I will go into the city. And I just explained why I said so. Through the rails, it could be... I thought I am streaming once again. General Blunder is going to be in the YouTube video. I have paranoia, fellas. The funny thing, when one day I was recording a YouTube video, I clicked stream together with recording. So what happened? People saw my recording, what I'm talking, what I'm doing, and it was just not funny. Let's say like that. I messed up. I'm not complaining. Don't get me wrong. Everything is fine, right? Subs out of nowhere is happening from time to time, and I very appreciate that. This is another way to support me, if I can say so. And a lot of people is wondering, how do I make my living and so on. So YouTube and streaming is my how I make my living. YouTube is not so much. YouTube is more likely like a hobby, because let's get real, YouTube is not, you know, with the YouTube you are not going to make a billion unless you are a PewDiePie, right? This is obviously a joke. Speaking of Twitch is a better idea for me. And I can spend more time on the Twitch, and probably I enjoy that kind of experience more than on YouTube. Why so? I can tell you why. Very, very simple answer to your question right there. On the Twitch, you are talking with a person live, okay? So, for example, there is one guy which is saying, hi, Skill, I can say hi to him back. In the YouTube, yes, there is a comment section which I'm working on. I am reading the comments pretty much all the... Wow, that was nice thing. Did you saw you can hit people through this gap over there? Because this is a first for me. Very nice. I did not knew that before. Well, what can I say? You are living and you are learning. We are trying to side scrap right there. That was beautiful track. And if this person don't have repairs, he is doomed. Look. Look at the DPM of this tank. Most important thing about this vehicle, DPM. Look. This guy is melting. He is melting like ice cream in the summer day. Easy game. Look. Bye-bye. That's what happened in this game. Okay, TS5. TS5 have amazing DPM too. DPM of the TS5 is very, very, very good, and not much what I can do for this guy. Well, apart taking one for the team, right? TS5 just ate me, and he did everything properly right here, so I have no rights to complain about this this battle. Once again, a highlight about this vehicle. Caernarvon, good DPM, but not that good as TS5 DPM is, right? TS5 is the tank which have very, very... which have insane DPM and which have quite some armor. I could load the gold on him, but it would not be... it would not make a massive difference right here. I would die anyways, and we have no team. We are just melting. One or another way, that was experience with a Caernarvon. I like this tank, no matter you are having that kind of games. You can play with the best tank in the world of tanks. But there is a chance you are going to have a bad battle anyways, right? I'm feeling happy, and let's move on to the tier 9 to the tier 9, okay? That's what we are planning to do. And with the tier 9, my main mission will show you the Conqueror and the Super Conqueror performance. Probably I will play two games with a tier 9 and maybe even 3 games with a tier 10, but probably it's going to be 2 because we played like 2 games with this one, 2 games with this one, 1 game with this one, just for the time purposes for you fellas, because let's get real. Not many of you are going to watch the full Tech 3 showcase, which is completely understandable, and not everyone has like 2 hours time of to watch a YouTube video. And it's completely understandable, don't get me wrong, I am not complaining. Anyways, let's check the last battle which we had. I tried to do my best, unfortunately I could not play under the bridge because of the Arthas, so... yeah, that kind of stuff is happening. And right here, yeah, with this kind of team, that's about right. And this TS5, he have amazing DPM and he can eat me like nothing, which is completely understandable. Did that TS5 message us? Oh, yes, he did. Sorry, man, it wasn't focused. No problem, you played the game. So it's fine, you don't need to be afraid to shoot me or something, you know? So everything is fine. By the way, sir, you are in YouTube video. All good, I don't mind. Okay, so tier 9, easy. Let's go and let's deal with that, right? And I just had amazing performance with a Conqueror. Amazing performance. One shot. Situation. Took one for the team from Jack Pizda, and after that I got effed by the Arthas. Red Shire. That did not work too well, but okay, stuff like this is happening, and once again, I'm not afraid to show that kind of things, right? So I'm accepting that. Better luck next time. Like I mentioned before, Super Heavis is not the tanks which I would enjoy the most. Conqueror is not even close for being my favorite tank. In fact, I don't like it. Same goes for a Super Conqueror. I'm not saying they are bad tanks by any means, don't get me wrong, they are very good tanks. But every single person have his favorite, have his style, okay? And for my style, is definitely not a Super Conqueror. Mm-mm. It is not a Super Conqueror. It's not Conqueror. Give me 5A. Give me 4A. Give me 277. Give me medium tank. Give me something who have mobility like T10. And you can keep a Conqueror for yourself. Yes, it's a powerful tank, but I don't like this kind of game style, right? But in the same time, a lot of people love it. So, you know, this is a Tech 3 showcase and this is what this line is all about. Anyways, what we are planning to do here, we are planning to take this position over there, and more likely this game is going to be good. If I'm not going to get clicked, but I don't want to play in this city. Probably the most important thing is I don't really have patience maybe to play with a hold down heavies, because if you are making some mistakes, right, you might get punished quite a bit for that. So probably that's what I don't really like. Maybe. Anyways, let's see what we can do here. They have a lot of people over there. This guy just made a mistake. That was a big fat mistake by AMAX. T10, 140 is gone for me. Big mistake by 140. Big mistake. And we are just wasting their repairs right there. This tank have insanely good DPM in my opinion. It has insanely good gun handling. It is very powerful tank if you are using this tank correctly. How you can use it correctly? Well, in my opinion, the correct use of this tank is to sit hold down and just to try to punish enemies if they are doing something stupid. And this is stupid. And this is simply stupid, fellas. As you can see, this guy is getting tracked, and now we are enjoying a meal of the standard beef. Can this guy do something for us? No. He can spam heat, he can spam high explosives, it's not going to help for him. And this is the beauty of the Conqueror and Super Conqueror. They are not immortal, but they have a decent armor against the heat. So not all the time second button is helping. How to deal with this tank? Frontal mantlet or cupola with the heats could work very well. Other than that, it's not that easy to deal with this vehicle. Plus, gun handling is very, very good on this tank. This is not a joke, this is reality. Gun handling is actually super good on this tank. And you have very nice view range of it too. I'm talking about this tank, obviously. So it's very powerful tank, and in the right hands it can be even more powerful. Unfortunately, fellas, my hands is not the ones probably. But look, when this vehicle and this line is one of the most powerful lines of the heavy tanks, in my opinion, right? That's what I think. So heavy tanks lovers, if you are out there which is watching this Tech 3 showcase, I want to believe this is the line for you. I'm trying to figure out what do I want to do against those people right there. T95 right in the track. Arta just hit me. 140 is going for me. Luckily, he took one for the team, and I'm just going to track this guy right there. Tracking the T95 is going to mean for us a lot of tracking damage. And that was just beautiful. Meanwhile, 140 was trying to go for us. That did not work too well for this poor soul. And right there, I want to hit his cupola. That was not the best one, but it's fine. We are out of APs for now, but it's not a bad thing for us. We still can do a lot of bad things for this person. Dead, no? Unfortunately, I did not manage to punish him into his cheek, and T49 just peekaboo. He said peek, and he got me. It's okay, it's not a bad game by any means. We have a solid 6,000 combined, 3,000 damage, 3,000 assisting / tracking damage. Speaking for the marks, we have 5.2. It's okay, not a big deal. I am going to play one more battle with this tank, and hopefully we will have even better game than this. Let's hope so. I will come back when everything will be over, as usual. And we are back. That was victory, I'm happy with that, and that was quite easy game, I would say, right, fellas? So 1,000 damage, 2,900 assisting damage, we are top on the scoreboard, good. Let's go for another one. So one more battle with a Conqueror. After that, two more games with a Super Conqueror, which is basically the same Conqueror, but it's tiny touch better. And now I have a question for you. How many of you are thinking you got a message in the TeamSpeak? Huh? Very nice. Someone is poking me. I'm not here. Okay. So, what do we want to do in this map? I want to believe, fellas, since it's not worth to push through the city, I will take a middle, and hopefully it's going to be a good performance by us, right? So, I hope so, and I want to believe that. Yeah, you never know how everything will go. Anyways, the first... What you can do in this map with a Conqueror and Super Conqueror? I really like this position because you can cover, like, all sides. Or alternatively, you can try to push like this, but if they will have a hold down tank destroyer there like T30, I will have quite some problems, so I don't really think it's worth it. Sip of the coffee while we are traveling. Good, very, very good. And everything should work well for us. We have insanely good matchmaking right here. I mean, we are playing against the lower tiers, like Minus two in minus two matchmaking right here, so everything should go pretty much well. This Vazay is thinking he have a good position. In reality, he is so damn wrong. That should be a shot from our side. Good, and now we are going to take this position over there. Meanwhile, while we are playing in this position, oh boys, this is going to be beautiful. It's not that easy to do some things for those people towards us, right? At least I don't really think it's very, very easy. And right there, fellas, look. We are going to wait until we are going to get unspotted, but there is a tiny chance it's not going to happen, right? We might be spotted for all that time. But one or another way, I'm not complaining. This guy is dead. He tried to reverse side scrap or something, but that did not work too well for this person, right? IS2 is waiting for us until we are going to peek, and you know what? We will peek in like 2 seconds. 1, 2. Let's see. I can't see that as shame. Pyongst. Right into the defender's side, just like this. We punished him. And this position, fellas, is extremely powerful in my eyes. It is extremely good position, but in the same time, you must focus. You must check, have a good awareness, and you can get this position to work for sure. And as you can see, pay attention at the maxi map or mini map, whatever you are using, and just try to punish everyone which is doing one or another stupidity. It can be done, and then you will get the maximum use of this area over there. And it's just super duper hyper turbo good in my opinion. It's just super good. One blind over there, but we did not hit that light, which is completely understandable. And now we will try to find maybe a shot on that light tank, which I unfortunately but failed. It's okay. If you would pay attention over there, fellas, looks like the IS2 is making some... Oh, that was no bueno. And that was no bueno. Apparently, they have a T30 sniper schnitzel over there. Can I do something for him? No. Negative. Unfortunately, we cannot do anything to this guy. That's a bit of shame, to be honest. And now I don't really want to take this position over there because they have autoloader in this position. Ay. Well, not the best start of the game, but hey, what can you do? Look at this, was a tank destroyer. I think we did not hit him, which was unfortunate, but it's okay. We will hit him very, very soon. Pyongst. Nope. Unfortunately, RNG is saying, no, you did not deserve it to hit that one. RNG, could we please hit this one, please? Pyongst, RNG said affirmative. Very, very nice. Beautiful aiming, beautiful shot, all good. How about this 257 now? Can we find a shot into this guy? That would be glorious and that would be very, very nice. And sure we can. Meanwhile, T30 is making pressure like this and this T54 is over there. Am I afraid of that T54? Obviously not. Mm-hmm. Yep. I was about to kill that guy, but that did not work it out that well as I expected. And we still can get a lot of use of all this. All we need to do, we need to focus on the game. I see that Ruski tank and I see that autoloader. I'm kind of sitting in the shithole right there. I'm kind of sitting in the shithole right here and this guy managed to get me. Okay, let it be. What can you do about that? Not much. I'm accepting that and that was the game with a Super Conqueror. The most unfortunate thing for me, I got hit by that T30 earlier. I simply did not thought he's going to sit here for that long as a time, but that happened. And we managed to get 2.4 plus 490. Not very good game. What can I do? Not much. One more highlight, which I want to say once again, I'm not heavy tank player. I do not enjoy heavy tanks, and tanks like Super Conqueror, I know their potential, I know how powerful they are, I know I don't like those tanks. None of them. Super Conqueror, no. For me, it's 5 out of... Okay, it's 7 out of 10 tank. And funny fact, but I prefer way more VZ, heavy tank. Probably even 113 is better for me than a Super Conqueror, just because of my preferential and just because of my style, okay? Anyways, it's fine. We are not complaining and we are accepting the fate which we have right there. And now, the moment of truth, fellas. The tank which is the Super Conqueror. The tank which everyone is going for, right? And... I can tell you that it's very powerful tank. Armor wise, it's good. Power wise, it's super good. It's just amazing tank. And compared with the tank which we used to have before, this tank is called Please Lit Me on Fire. That's how this tank is called. If you are getting hit frontally, you will take one for the team. And I hated this tank with all my heart. Super Conqueror, obviously, it's way better than Fava ever was before. It's just tiny touch slower, if I'm not mistaken. Anyways, let's go and let's test this vehicle in the action, shall we? I got some free stuff from Wargaming once again. Very nice. By the way, for some people who don't know, Wargaming is celebrating 8th birthday in the EU server. So, happy birthday, Wargaming. Okay, let's see. Happy birthday, World of Tanks. This is probably the right way how I should say the things. We managed to win that battle. Probably our team captured the base. It's my guess. Oh yes, our team captured the base. It was not the great performance, but at least we was top on the damage, not top by experience. And this T-30 managed to punish me before. Let it be. It's fine. So, tier 10 Super Conqueror. I hope games are going to go well. Let's continue. Two games, come on, we have two chances. Very, very often, fellas, one more thing which I must admit and I need to highlight. Very, very often, when you are dealing against the Super Conqueror, you are going to have a situation when people are spamming the full gold on you. It's just the way it is. And fellas, we have community clans, if you are interested. If you are interested in that, information will be in the description. Anyways, why people are spamming full APCRs on this tank? Because there is no disadvantage while shooting APCRs, and it's flat better than APs. Apart the cost, right? So this is the thing which you need to keep in mind, fellas. Only cost is the different, but speaking of the game performance, if I'm not mistaken, shell velocity is better with APCRs. You have more penetration and it's just simply better. So there is quite some people which want to get maximum use in the game, and they are just doing that. And for example, when I played ranked battles myself, I was spamming the full gold with this vehicle. Next, what is more? When I was playing it for the third mark of excellence, when I was very, very close to get the mark, I was spamming the full gold too. For me, it's completely understandable, and I'm not one of those guys which is crying about the gold. It is in the game, and you can... I want to report a problem. My tank is a bit broken. Fellas, I want to report the problem. See? Wargaming support is working very, very well, and as you can see, the problem got fixed extremely quickly. He is going to get one more shot on me, more likely. Yeah. By the way, as a side scraper, Super Conqueror, I do not like this tank at all, and I don't really think it is a good side scraper. And Super Conqueror, in my eyes, this is the tank with which you need to, instead of side scrapping, you need to get into hold-down position, and then you can shit on everyone. So what I did right there against this Centurion, it was idiotic, and I played like a... like a very, very special person right there. That was just bad. Meanwhile, enemy Arta is shitting on the type 5, and I don't really like what I'm seeing here, but hey, I will try to get maximum use of all this, right? Anyways, now APCR's on. Why? Because you are seeing mouse. If you think I'm going to aim for a lower plate of the mouse, you are out of your mind. It's just not going to be the case, and it's not good idea. Meanwhile, enemy Arta is sitting right there. Can we do something for enemy Arta? Yes, we can report him for unsportsman conduct. This is only one thing how you can play against Arta. And if you are getting pissed off, feel free to do that. Why so? Why am I saying that? There is only one way how you can defend yourself. And I mean it, fellas. I mean it. Because it's fair and balanced. And I never ever show the hate for Arta players. There is a guys which is enjoying the game, whatever. They are doing whatever they want to do, and everything is fine with that. I don't like this gaming mechanic itself. I think it's poorly balanced, and it's just bad, if I can say so. It is just bad, fellas. That's why I hate it, and it's definitely not adding some kind of enjoyment in the game or something. But once again, maybe it's only me, and maybe I'm special. Also, could be a possibility. The Centurion action 10 is just tapping on our team like nothing. Okay, look. In this kind of situation, for those situations, I have high explosives. Yes, I see that mouse, which is. Game is just treating me like a special guy right here. It's very unfortunate, but I'm accepting that. Anyways, this mouse is getting closer right here, and I really want to help our Type 5 here if he needs some help. Since we are going like this, more likely we are going to take one for the team from the enemy Arta. At least that's what I want to believe. Our Kranwagen is trying to deal with this Mr. Mouse. And fellas, when you are playing with Mr. Mouse, you are going to have those situations quite often. When you can do whatever you want, people is going to go on the full APCRs or full hits or whatever. And you are not going to enjoy yourself too much. But this is a part of the game, so not much what you can do about that, right? Well, apart complaining. This is probably only one thing which you can do. Mm-hmm. This guy will try to shoot me. He missed the shot. Well, he actually hit at the lower plate, but our lower plate was an insanely big angle, so that just worked in our favor. What do I want to do now? I want to make a pressure towards this T10. That was quite terrible shot by me, and the same disgusting Arta is shitting on me. Well, this is the main reason why I hate heavy tanks, like I mentioned before. Why do I... this is just the main reason why heavy tanks is so... This is the simply main reason why I do not... like to play with the heavy tanks, because Arta is going to claim your life anyways, and it's not very bueno. At least it's not very bueno for me. Look at those sweet APCRs right there. You are just going through jackpiece the superstructure like nothing. Like literally nothing, fellas. And it's definitely a good thing, right? It is definitely a good thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and as you can see, T10 made a mistake, he paid the price for his stupidity. This tank is ideal when you are a hold down. When you are a hold down, fellas, people cannot do too much stuff for you. You have very, very, very nice DPM. This is definitely the thing which needs to be highlighted. You have extremely good gun handling, and you can enjoy yourself quite a bit with this tank. That's why people like it. Super Conqueror is not the... It's not very easy tank to play with. I must admit that. But if you are getting the right point how to play with this vehicle, you can have so much fun, and you can enjoy yourself quite a bit. Let's say like that. Can we blind fire Arta? for sake of RNG. I have 3 more tries for love RNG. Let me do this, please. I want to find that clicker. I am meeting this clicker for quite some times already. I remember his name. He did not click at me for a very first time right there. Or maybe it's only my imagination, right? Also could be true. Well, as you can see, I did not manage to find the art. Better luck next time. Also, one more thing which I definitely want to highlight. I like to go with the blind shots no matter what. Because you are missing every single blind shot which you are not taking, right? So I would rather to test it out. I would rather to try to hit that, and hopefully then it would be way... then you can get those amazing performances, right? Anyways, that was the game. 4,500, it was very, very far away from the perfection with this vehicle, but I tried to do everything what I could. Once again, fellas, I am not the best heavy tank player, but I am trying to do everything what I can. And for me, the most painful marks right here is to get Mark of Excellence on the heavy tanks. But one another way, we have a 5,000 damage, we have 2,600 blocking damage, which was fine. And this Paton, he carried this game quite well, so GG to him, right? Let's go for one more battle and let's finish everything up with a good game, good map, Glacier. Very nice. We have... the shittest thing of all this, there is 2 artists, which is definitely not very good, but hey, what can we do about this? Nothing. So, how we are going to deal with this situation? I believe, we are going to go to the Delta 4, and hopefully from the Delta 4 we can punish the heavy tanks. Actually, I have another idea. I could take even this position over there, but I'm not sure which one of those is better. Do I want to go into the heavy line? I don't want to go to the Charlie 1, Bravo 1, Alpha 1. Yeah, I don't really want to do that, so I won't. I will play in the middle. And after that, I can complain about the Artas. Okay. I have a feeling, fellas, the best idea for us is going to be to take the position next to the 907. Hopefully it's going to work well. And speaking of the Super Conqueror on the flat ground, like on the flat ground like this, this is far away from being like super heavy tank. The Super Conqueror, best things about the Super Conqueror is gun, obviously, DPM, obviously, and the gun handling. So pretty much everything with a gun and armor. But armor is working only hold down, so don't think the armor is going to be insanely good with this tank when you are not hold down. By the way, this guy is yelling on me and he's saying, Art is relocating, did you saw that? Because I saw that. He moved back. Come on. Yeah. RNG. Last time you did not hit that, Art. Can you do that now? Fellas, we got him. Oh, boys. That blind shot deserved a medal, okay? Where is my medal game? Where is my medal? That was solid high explosive into the moving art like this. This guy was relocating, so keep that in mind. I saw the bush which... I saw the tree which fallen right there. That was just... Solid shot from our side. I'm happy, fellas. Anyways, what do we want to do now? Now I want to take the position next to the T-30 and 430, and we will try to get some use of those guys over there. Also, I might try to go up the hill. The reason why I'm thinking about going up the hill, because though we don't have that many heavies here and they have more forces, so it could be just smart and very, very good. So, I think Progetto right there is not even here, so I am just going in front very aggressively. See, it's working. Good, let's go. I'm so happy after that, Arta Blanchot, you have no clue. I could finish this game with a 1000 damage right there and I would be happy. If you are wondering how do I hit those blind shots, I'm just hacking. Nothing unusual, fellas. Every one of you knows I'm a hacker, so I see just more things than anyone else. That's how hacks is working. Anyways, right there, we are going to take this position and we will try to shit on this standard Conqueror and on this 705 tier 9. So everything is looking pretty good. Everything is looking pretty good, fellas, for sure. So pir getting there. Pir. This tank also has a very, very nice gun depression. So pay attention what we are going to do now. Not a big deal. The thing is, do you see those guys which made a pressure in front? I can tell you that they are going to regret their decision right there, because this T-30 is sitting in the shithole. And this is the position where you want to be with this tank. Look, pay attention right there. I'm hold down, this T-30 have a lower ground, he can't do anything for me, I'm claiming his life, and in the same time I'm just smiling. So this guy is pretty much dead meat, he cannot do anything right there. Well, unless RNG is going to treat him well, because that was a bounce from his ass. But hey, what can you do? Easy game. He doesn't have gun elevation, so I will try to hit him once again. Actually, it's too hard. Now we want to load high explosives. Why? Because this griller will move. Since this griller will move, we will try to get the shot on this griller from over there, right? This is the main point of all this. Auto-aim piston to the griller, minus 500. Griller is not feeling very good, but hey, look at the bright side. I am 550 in the poor griller. Griller hashtag never lucky. Object is sniping me, but this griller had no chance to deal with me by any means. And now we will work on this E5 right there. This is the position where you want to be with a super conqueror. And also, speaking of the super conqueror, fellas. And also, speaking of the Super Conqueror, this tank have pretty good armor. This armor is not bad by any means, and you can punish people for pretty much everything. Also, I would love to jump on those guys. Maybe I will do that in the end of the battle. You know I have addiction for jumping. I believe you heard that before, right? So. Yeah. Too bad we did not manage to finish this guy off, but what can you do? Arta is dead in a second. And now we are going to go for this object. Object is dead, good. Are you ready for jump? Soon, fella, soon. Give me some more time and we are going to jump right there. Okay. I need to make sure I have a good angle. Hop.
Bad ending. I knew I did not need to do that. I knew it.
My name is Skell, and I have a problem. I'm jumpaholic, fellas, and not much what I can do about that. If I see the victim on which I could jump, I am jumping. I hope I did not throw this battle away. I hope this 907 is going to carry this game, because there is quite a big chance. Nah, there is no chance we are going to lose, because we have IS-7 which have quite some health and everything is going to be fine. Well, I would say this battle was quite entertaining. The blind shot on the moving Arta, it was golden. It was, I should get a Nobel, how it's called, the Nobel Award for it. Humble YouTuber, by the way. It was just ideal. The jump was only 1 out of 10. It was not that good. But you know, I have addiction and I'm jumping sometimes. And not much what I can do right there. So yeah. One or another way, it was beautiful, 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 beautiful game. I enjoyed myself and I had quite some fun. The Churchills killed my spirit a bit. But in the end of the day, we got enough use. And that blind shot on that Arta. On the moving Arta. That was beautiful, and we finished at the top on the damage and the third of the experience. It was solid banana out of 10. Well, only jump was bad, but what can you do? Not much. So, before we are going to end everything, fellas, there are some premium tanks which I want to talk about. Excelsior, in my opinion, this tank is just not worth it. It's not very good, it's not worth it, and I would say, this tank is just no bueno. Tog, if you like pain, get a Tog. Fava, very low alpha damage, but it can work. Do I recommend buying this tank? No. Caernarvon Action 10. In my opinion, Caernarvon Action 10 is worse than standard Caernarvon because of the gun. If you would pay attention right there, there is a difference of the alpha damage. And since Caernarvon, normal Caernarvon have a better... better alpha, and I think the armor is better on the standard Caernarvon. That's why I think this one is better than this one, but it's only me. And also, speaking about this one, this vehicle, it is controversial tank. Some people will love it, some people will hate it. I don't like this tank. I like Patriot way more, but it's only me, right? And the Fava is basically the worst version of the Super Conqueror. I never ever played good with it, and I have a big problems because this tank is burning like crazy. So I just don't like it. And you can't get this tank nowadays, so it doesn't matter, right? So thank you so much for watching, fellas. It was a big pleasure to make this video. I hope you enjoyed this as much as I did, and I hope you understood the sarcastic parts here. And thank you so much for watching. And also, for people which decide to join the patrons, people which are supporting me in that way, thank you so much once again. That's very, very, very kind of you, and that means a world for me. So thank you. Let's go, fellas.